Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to learn how to create a stack using CloudFormation. So let's get started. So first of all, I'll be searching for CloudFormation. On opening this, I will be then creating a stack. And now you can see that here are different options available for the template, right? So in this case, first of all, if we already have got a template of any of the resources that we want to configure, then we can directly make use of this template is ready. And in case we want to use any kind of a sample template where we want to use template which is already there, or just a sample template just for testing purpose, then we can make use of user sample template. And the other thing is about create template in designer. So there is a feature of designer in this particular option wherein we can, with the help of just selecting the template and implementing it and also viewing it, can be done using this designer. Now, in case I want to work with EC2 instance, so you can see that there is an option of EC2 instance out here. So you can directly take it over here and you can see that this template gets created automatically once we pull it out. So basically it is a graphical representation of whatever instance, and at the same time there is a template using JSON as well as YAML format. So with the help of designer also you can create the instance, but we'll use a template which we already have. Okay, we'll be using that. So I'll be using template is ready, and for specifying a template which is in the form of JSON or YAML file, I'll be uploading a template file since I don't want to use Amazon S3 as of now. So now I will be choosing a file which is present in this particular location. Now let's discuss more about the template. This is the template for an EC2 instance, which is simply where we have mentioned the availability zone, the image ID, the instance type in the properties. And for the resources, we have selected my instance type to be AWS EC2 instance. So that's it for now. Just try to understand. Don't jump on conclusions about any of the code syntax, like how is the code syntax, what all properties are available. For time being, just focus on understanding a simple template where you can easily understand that the resource is named my instance of type this particular EC2 has to be created along with these many properties. So as of now, just try to understand and don't focus on the code syntax as of now. Okay, so now that we have added this file over here, we'll go and click next. Now in this case, I'll be entering the stack name, which is my stack for EC2 instance. Okay, so this is the name that I've given. Parameters, you can, there are no parameters defined in your template, so it will automatically come if any of the parameters are mentioned. We can also add tags to all the resources that we are creating through this particular stack. I will be adding name as my instance. Okay, we can also assign a role to the resources that are getting created using stack, using this particular stack. Then we have got stack failure options, like if our stack fails, then it should roll back all the stack resources. So we have selected this, or else we can also preserve successfully provisioned resources. So this feature is also available, but I will go with rollback for as of now. Rest of the things I'll keep it as it is. As of now, just for the understanding purpose, this is a sample stack that we are creating to understand the working of CloudFormation. So this is the review page. So you can see that the template URL is this, which is getting stored in an S3 bucket, right? And we haven't entered these details, so we are good for as of now. And submit. Now you can see over here that our status is create in progress, because it has just initiated the task, and slowly after some time, after a few events, it will give us create completed. So in this you can see that within the stack info we have got the stack ID, the status of progress, and many the thing, the time at which it got created, tags that we want to assign. So everything comes under stack info. Now you can see in the events, this is the most important tab, wherein it will show the stepwise events taking place, right? So first it was user initiated, then resource creation initiated. So this is the stack ID, events, resources. So you can see that the resource named my instance is already created in our EC2 management console. Now you can see that the instance has got created, and the region that we have specified has also been the same one. Everything is according to our requirements mentioned in the YAML file. Then comes is the outputs. We'll see these things in the later videos, parameters, template. So you can see that this was the template that was used by CloudFormation, which we already uploaded here. So hope you understood the content of the video, and please like, share and subscribe the channel if you found the video really useful. Also, don't forget to press that bell icon so that you will get all the updated videos. Thank you so much. Have a nice day.